Vi skal få inn noen flere gjester, og den som kommer nå, hun har navnet Florian Cloud Bonvial O'Malley Armstrong. Så man kan jo forstå behovet for kortversjonen Dido. Med låter som Thank You, Stan og White Flag har vår neste gjest stått for noen av de bestselgende albumene i brittisk musikkhistorie. For ingen synger helt som henne. Want to thank you for giving me the best day of my life. No, just to be with you is having the best day of my life. Please welcome Dido.
Welcome. Welcome. Hi.
I was struggling a bit with your name here. I know, and I probably didn't pronounce it right. Should I call you Dido or should
yes.
I call you not Florian?
I've never even been called all those other names, and I think my mum just sort of came up with these names, and then called me Dido. She christened me some names, and then called me another one.
So
indecisive.
But your mother christened you all these days, and your father had nothing to do with it?
Well, I think he was a bit surprised on the christening day. There'd been a few more in contention, and then she just swept in with those ones.
Because it's... Florian
is actually a German man's name, I think. Yeah, so I often get called Mr. Dido. It all gets very confusing in hotels. It's sort of, Mr. Dido is my new name.
I know you have a brother. You're working with him. He's your producer.
Yes.
What's he called?
He's called Rollo. Roland Constantine O'Malley Armstrong.
What kind of parents did you have?
Well, they with my names, apparently, they were driving around France while pregnant with me and getting names from signposts and you know, who knows? My mum's a poet and my dad was a publisher.
So you're from a writing family?
Yes, and my husband's a writer as well. And my brother writes too.
Oh, I see.
So everybody writes.
Okay, so you kind of are in the same business.
All I do is write songs. So they're smaller. Everyone else manages bigger things than me.
Are you the contentment type or are you the roller coaster type?
I think I've been both. I used to, when I was on the roller coaster, I would just crave the contentment phase, and then I used to think maybe it only feels like true contentment if there's been a bit of roller coaster going on, so you really can feel it. But actually, having had a child now, I would say I'm pretty much off the roller coaster. I used to be so restless, you know, like I couldn't stop moving, and you know, I'd come home from tour and have to just get on a plane and go anywhere a week later. And since having Stanley, it's just like, I just love being with him, being at home. Those are the happy things.
She's also off the roller coaster, you know?
Yes.
Very young. She'll hop on it very soon.
She'll hop on it.
And, no, I just, yeah, for me...
If you get we have this crisis, men have this crisis called the 40-year crisis.
Right.
Have you had it?
Well, I'm 41. I definitely had a bit of a wobble around my 40th birthday. I actually fell off a treadmill on my 40th birthday.
roller coaster.
Yeah, exactly. I literally came off the roller coaster on my 40th birthday.
Let's do this again. You fell off a treadmill?
Yeah, quite badly on my 40th birthday.
Just having a treadmill, that's very 40-year crisis, you know?
Well, exactly. And on your birthday as well. Like, I woke up and thought, I'm 40, I need to start running. It's time to get fit. If I don't do it now, I'm never going to do it. And then promptly fell off.
But how do you fall off?
Well, actually, it's quite difficult.
He was running backwards.
Yeah. I wouldn't dare do that.
Not on a treadmill.
No, exactly. No, I actually walked across it, forgetting it was on. to get my bottle of water. It was, and I literally went flying, and my husband heard this sort of almighty crash from upstairs.
So it felt like sideways?
Yeah, and was sort of hanging on and scraped like all the front of my legs, everything. Yeah, no, it's horrible. Still got scars. And he came up, of course he laughed, because it was just so Laurel and Hardy, sort of
you were
proper.
Very, very hurt. And he
yeah, I was sort of crying and laughing. So he couldn't not laugh. It was pure comedy.
You've had no such accident. I mean, you can do everything backwards.
Again, there's no wood, but luckily, no I haven't.
Yeah. Not even on the treadmill. That's incredible.
No.
Thank you so much a few minutes more before you're going to sing for us.
Yes.
But we're having another guest in here, and I'm going to say something in Norwegian now. Right. Men nå det Daido som har inntatt scenen. Dette No Freedom.
No love.